Hey, John here. It's Tuesday today, 8th of November 2016. I'm just ringing Willie Peita. The chief in Hapu. Kia ora, Willie. How are you? I've been talking to Jim, Wikotu, and he's going to come up here with me and go up there. Yeah, this morning. Oh, sorry, Jim, I was ringing Willie Peita. I pushed the wrong button, and I think, hey, he sounds different today. Yeah, oh no, you got those things? Yeah, they freak out, all right, because they're part of the whole puzzle. And they'll have to come up with something, even if they put a hui on, you put a hui on down there, or come down there. And... Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's all right, that'll be good, because I can make it clearer, but... Yeah, that's right, they have to change gear. And because it's stuck in the Te Ture Whenua, it's stuck fast to a rock. Yeah, no, that's right, because that's my crew down in Gisborne, the Hurauta and Waikare Moana. Yeah, that's all right, because, yeah. Yeah, no, that's okay, anywhere there in Gisborne with those fellas over there. They should know, because it's the key to unlocking everything. Yeah, no, that's right. You just arrange it and it'll come out for the good for everybody, no matter what. It has to go back to that start point. And Yeah, it's on the net. The net, it makes a big difference, because the whole world's watching where they're going to get freed. This flag is going to free the whole lot of them. Because they're caught up with the same queen, you see. Yeah, it's got to end. It's because it's got to have a new lease contract. Of the land. It's the land, it's the navy behind everything. Yeah. Now that put them on notice that the next time we're around, it's for good. It's what you're saying. That's the end. That's the end. And yeah, no, that's right. They couldn't interpret it into these terms of cashing. Yeah, how to put a document together to get the cash out of it. That's all it is. That's all this flag is. It's a bank flag. If you use it, you'll end up with it. Yeah. So you wonder why there's no British ship coming. It's because if it came, we'd use them to get rid of them. Yeah, that's all. Yeah. No, that's the big thing. Yeah, the internet does it because it's got a wider audience than just here. Yeah, it notifies. Yeah, that's right. It puts them on notice straight on their page. Yeah, it's got on their page. I put it on in front of the U.S. Secretary of Defense, and yeah, that their warship is coming, but it's coming here to usurp this flag of Admiralty. You see, you wonder why they. You want, huh? Yeah, it's left Hawaii already, it's on its way. But, Pacific. In the Pacific, at least in the Pacific, they're coming here with their 12 nations TPP, and they'll enforce that here with John Key, with this Admiralty, and the new Governor Pākehā, Governor General. With Mataparai, the Maori in England, giving consent from that end where the Queen has left the hole and he's jumped in it. You see? She's in the EU Parliament running from there, through the States and here, and then back to England. She's come around the back door, and because she can't come directly to us, because it's in a mess, it's in a political mess now in the States with Trump. Eh? They're still using this. Yeah, they're still using an Admiralty ship to get their thing across. Right? And the captain. Yeah, that's right. We're going in there to take it off inside the marae and trap them inside the court. You see, we tell them inside the court, you give them notice to their face. And they can't do anything about it because they don't have the contract. You have it. I write up the contract here from the old contract. And all they can't match it because they haven't got any other than a chief, a native chief. And they're talking to the wrong ones. Yeah, Paraoni. Peita Paraoni is a brown dressed up as a Paraoni. You see? Yeah, I know. That's what I mean. They've got a brown chief, but he's dragged it off. Into the Pākehā side. Yeah, Brown, that's his real name. All those fellows up there in Mataribe and all that, they all changed their names. And that's why they can't substantiate who they are. They won't say they come from out in the sea somewhere. Yeah, now when you... Well, see, the tangata whenua is one thing, the mana whenua is another. That's what I'm saying. The mana whenua is that MOAI statue standing in London, and they put one down in Dunedin for the Pākehās down there. So that one's got a crown on his head. He's got a hat on his head. That's the crown they're using. That the mana whenua, because it's got his base on it, that's the whenua. And the body, that's the mana. And the hat on the top, that's the crown title, the crown that they're using in Dunedin. And the one in London, they whipped the crown off that for the Queen, you see? That's our Tahiti, doesn't matter, that's us as a memorial to the land. Yeah, so that's all it is. They've got their obelisk outside Te Tī Marae, that's John Key. He should be on that marae, we should be on the other side, because that's his memorial there. Ours is that ship, that mast. That's not his contract, that's ours. Yeah, that's what we're going in there. Yeah, he can go over there in that one because he's got no carvings in it. All carvings is in the other one. You see, so we just swap places. So I was talking to that. He knows. But, so he'll be ready this time around. And all I have to do is get your lot down there. Those incorporations, right, because they have to look after the land with their business on the TT side. They have to still go through that process, right? And what I'm doing is I go and deal it from British and go and rate those fellows to make these fellows change. right? You have to alter the whispering sign on that end, not this end. The Torefenua is on that end, right? So I have to go back to that end and get a mandate from the chiefs in there to go in front of John Key, you see? That's how you do it. It's quicker. Yeah. No, it whips their title. It whips their title off because it's only a lease, you see? A British lease, not the Australian one, a British lease that goes and whips all the titles off them. Yeah. So it'll give a mandate straight to Westminster, and they have to cough up on that end to sort out. That what'll happen? Yeah, what'll happen is because the British ship is not here, it we just tell the British ship to go and sort them out, right? The Admiralty part of the mortgage. That's all it is, the mortgage lien. Yeah, it's a mortgage over the land, anything, any property or anything. And so, I'll just do little clips all the time, videos, and then it's quicker that way. Yeah. Oh, what's that? What? Say what? Yeah, because they are going under the royal queen, and all that money is being provided for the navy to look after the country. But because we got no money to pay them, the government here pays the money. But once we get the thing into Westminster, the Westminster will pay for the navy to work for us here. You see, and all those navy. All I want to do is snap all the navies up. Yeah. All I have to do is snap all the navies coming here and put them on notice back to Britain and let the British government and their navy sort that lot out. Because they override, because they're liable to us as a partner to our business with this flag between us and them, nobody else. You see? So I think you've got it, but... Yeah, so with the incorporations, they still have to run the business the way they want to, but once we get the Westminster Inn opened up, they can do what they like with their business, how they want to run it. But on a grand commercial scale overseas, it's very difficult for them to get on that level. Yeah. No, it's too difficult. I'd better to go straight onto a British system right up to date that's more ahead of New Zealand, straight from their laws. What's that? Yeah, that's right. But so that's why I'm saying I'm using the British system of today to go straight on, because it goes straight on the world stage. And we're straight out, we've got to go with this flag all the way around the world. That's where I'm following, where it's gone. And just once we got New Zealand sorted, then it puts the Queen side out and us in, you see? That's the only way to get one shot over the land. Not worth getting one bit here and one bit there, and that's what the government make. Everybody jump on one bit and one bit, and before long, there's too many bits, right? This just whops them one shot. If you got the native title and they can't send you. If we had a court hearing in there and you say, who has title, and they won't have it, see? So you say, well, that's it, we have the title, see? I'll just pull it out and say, well, here it is. What have you got? And that's it, if we need to go that far. Yeah, we got the answers, because you're standing there and we're giving them notice that they haven't got a British lease to show us. No, they only got an Australian one, John Key. It's not straight to Britain. Britain overrules what they've got, but we haven't used that power yet. We're just starting to... Yeah. No, you did the right thing doing that, because it's made made the whole world see what's going on here with that flag. A flag is everything in a country. Yeah, that's... Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. So that... Because he's talking from a British end. He's talking from the other end. That's where the Tulifena is in Westminster, because it's a British thing. It's a contract. It's a contract with us, and the government's using it here, and we can tell them... Yeah, yeah. See, Australia's using the Te Ture Whenua Act over there, the 93 Act on their Commonwealth Government of Australia. Commonwealth, yeah, they're using it, and then they use it in Canada and America. They're using our native 93 Act. You have a look, it's 93 Act in Australia. They won't tell you where it came from. Mm. Yeah, yeah, that's right. They put a patent on the honey. We got our own patents under the MOAI brand and King William brand on that flag. I'm pushing the flag. I'm pushing the flag because it takes command of all the seas, right? And that's why I wanted. Yeah, yeah. So that's what I'm saying. That's why I held off the tidal turbines, put them in the water, the big ones, and the seaweed and all the egg farms and everything until the flag was cleared, then dropped the whole lot out. And that'll take care of everything. You see? That'll take right through the world. The hydrogen economy, we'll be running that. We'll be running the hydrogen economy, right? Straight from the Hapu. Yeah, that's all right. You can stay here with me. Yeah, come and stay here, and we'll go up on my car. We can go up there at 5 o'clock in the morning, because it doesn't take long to get there. 6 o'clock in the morning, because it's 10 o'clock when the hui is. You see, we can sleep here and then go up early in the morning. Yeah, you stay here. This is your home over here. Okay. Okay, bye. Yeah, all right. I'll ring Willie now. Okay. I thought I was ringing Willie, but that was Jim. Wikotu. That's good. He's all excited because they're reading those documents, and they're shocked. Shocked their brains out. They can't believe their lucky stars. Willie Peita. Hello, Willie. How are you? I've just been talking to Jim this morning and now again. And him and I come up on the 18th still. That's right, he's going to come and stay here the night, and we'll come up, and it's at 10 o'clock, eh? 10 o'clock, yeah. Yeah, so that's right. He's arranging with Whanau Apanui and Horota Gisborne, he's arranging huis, so that I can go down there and put a presentation on there too. Okay. Yeah, so, but they're watching the videos I've just put up. With that warship coming in to Auckland. And you know, with all the warships coming here, 22 of them, from 22 countries, no British warship, nothing. You see? They won't send the British warship here, the Navy, because we can tell the Navy to shut them down. You see? Who's this? Britain? Yeah, yeah, that's true. That's true, and so is the United States. They're all changing now. If Clinton doesn't get in and Trump gets in, it all changes. Yeah, so it looks like Trump's going to get in, but we'll see. But anyway, that's all. I'm just checking with you to make sure the hui's on, and I'll be up there. It's a pity you haven't got an email, so I can send you the the videos and stuff that I'm sending down to those guys, but they're all in a state of shock of watching what I'm saying. It's better on video to explain each bit of what's going to happen on Waitangi Day. And I want to make sure that we get that one right, where John Key walks straight into it in front of us. All right? That's where the Jim's ready to put the flag up. He knows what to do there. And tell the Navy that their 882 lease at Kororareka is up and for renewal, and whether they want to go ahead and stay for some more, terminate it, then we'll go back to the British to get the title seized and reissued again, right? That's how it works. That's how to get the land back, is to get the British to do it. They've done it once before, in 1868, they seized all the titles and reissued them again. So we're going through that again. But it takes a while to get to know what to do and who to say it, right? But I think you've got, there's Manahi, Manahi Tangairi, he's one native chief. I just needed to have one more up that way, Hokianga across here, or the main area is Hokianga and Kororareka, I'm talking about, with that with the Waitangi Marae. That's the British title that I'm talking about. It's Hokianga where that captain of the Alligator went to, that ship, HMS Alligator, with that fellow, what's his name, George Lambert, okay? He went there to Hokianga first, then Kororareka. So it's between there and Kororareka where the history lines up to that one ship that put the title down there for in 1834. That's what I'm going on. Not the 1835, the 1834 one, okay? Yeah. It's better to, because I've got little videos of what I'm explaining about what happened at Kororareka, and that's all we have to worry about, Kororareka and Hokianga. Those are the two areas where that warship from Britain went to. It dropped into Hokianga first, then Kororareka, and that's the one I'm talking about. Yeah. It went from there, and that's where they put the first British title down, the legal one. All the rest of the titles were Australian, New South Wales ones. So we're at that point in time now where we need to give them the it's the Navy that holds the titles to the land anywhere. Okay. Yeah, not the government, but it's the Navy, and so all we have to do is. The Navy will be inside the Waitangi Marae. We'll be in there with you fellas, and that's where we tell them the lease is up. Are you going to stay or are you going to go? See? Yeah, that's on the lease agreement for the land use. That's all is the commercial part of the land use. They can stay there, but it's the lease that terminates the land, and the British will have to give us new titles. That's how it works. But I just want to let you know that we're coming out. Oh, somebody's phone going flat. That was all. You still there, Willie? Yeah. Anything else? You got any questions? Okay. Well, you can let me know your email when you get it so that I can fire you just the stuff I'm giving to Jim. And so we're on the same page. Okay. Bye. Yeah, that's Willie Peita. Those are my two confident chiefs, Willie Peita and Jim Wikotu. Two fellows I trust very much. That listens to what I say, not tells me what to do. They listen to what I say. Very good people. Okay, so Jim has been involved with Hohepa Mapiria, and so I'm familiar with all that incorporations. Nothing wrong with it, but it just doesn't fit into the British and the MOAI Hapu titles. It doesn't fit. You have to start from scratch. The 1993 Te Tiriti Whenua Act has been corrupted by the Queen Crown Corporations and John Key. It needs investigated. It needs to be left right out of this flag issue at 1834, right? Not 1835. That's for Te Tiriti Marae and the incorporations of the flag, that half. But the first title between Hokianga, that's where the settlement was with the Alligator, HMS Alligator, and its captain, George Lambert. Okay, he was responsible for going from there across the other side to Kororareka, where James Busby was setting up the native court. That's where the native court was, and the British government set up in Kororareka first with the Navy. Okay, that's the Navy, always the Navy, and the British flag, and this Admiralty flag right here, was legal the moment the flag of Britain went up. It made this one the flag here, and the British flag with the native, okay? The native and its flag was preordained by Te Re Waikato Whareherehere and the Waikato chief at Maunga Tautori and Hongihika in England between 1820 and 1830. That was set up with the native title. That's the one I'm talking about right there, where the ships were carrying those titles, okay, to the king, King William the Fourth. So we go back. The story there starts from Hokianga, but Hokianga wasn't a good site for the parliament, the government of Britain. They wanted the government in the Bay of Islands, where all the ships were coming in, trading, and the French and Americans and Australians, everybody was going there, where the trade was bustling and the west coast was too rough in the Hokianga side, and was easy access to get into the Bay of Islands, had more shelter for their ships. So that's the only reason why they changed from Hokianga over to the other side to set their government up at Kororareka or Russel. Okay, when Hone Heke cut down the flag after 1840, that's when they shifted the parliament, or the government, and the native court down to Auckland. And that's where the Manukau land titles came in from 1840 at the Manukau Heads. Captain William Cornwallis Simons, the captain of the ship, surrogate king like me, surrogate John Wanoa, that captain on his ship proclaimed the land on the Manukau Heads, the Manukau tribesmen's land, the biggest tribe in this country, the Manukau tribes, had pre-sold the land. Somebody had pre-sold that land there, and I'm picking it was Te Re Waikato Whareherehere had the title to that land from Glasgow in Scotland, Britain, to come straight in there and with the settlers from straight from Britain there. That was that point in time later, after Kororareka shifted its parliament to Auckland, after the Navy ships blew the whole place out with their cannon fire. Okay, so they, when they went down to Auckland, that's where they introduced, around that time, 1840, the new Manukau titles had kicked in from Cornwallis. And that village there is what I'm going on, okay? Between that title and George Lambert, Alligator, 21-gun salute. But Captain James Reedy Clendon, on his HMS Fortitude, was the man that hopped off his ship and proclaimed the land belongs to the king. Okay, those two ships in the harbour set off the 21-gun salute. At that period of time, the sale and purchase agreement went straight on with the immigrants off the boat to settle on that land they had bought, with a receipt, a deposit, and a sale and purchase agreement by Crown King William IV. Okay? Crown property. That's all I want to say there. I just put a little video of who I talked to, and I'm hoping that people watching this video or these videos in Porota, Gisborne, and Waikaremoana, Erna Renata, she's in Waikaremoana. Husband died before, but she's still holding the reins there in corporations. And those incorporations in Porota and Gisborne, I still have my Portigirua Ki Waipu incorporation in the days that we were working together there in Gisborne. I was going there every month to meetings. George Horsfall and Tau Tapu and in Juice and a few others. I can't name at the moment, but that's those seven incorporations were there at the meetings. Okay, so we can catch up again, but this time we're on a different wavelength with this flag. This flag, we had the flag in Gisborne with the Tau Tapu and George Horsfall. We had the flag flying on the marae there at the time of the incorporations where Titi Marae putting things together. So I still have all that information as well, but the Confederation is mostly what I'm after, is the whakamininga ahead of the Confederations. The whakamininga being 1834 and the Confederation being 1835. Two different parts of this flag. And I'm going only on the land title at Kororareka, where the British proclaim belongs to the king. That's it. That's where the buck stops. Okay, so I'm just writing to the Secretary of Defence in Westminster, Michael Fallon, to send the same letter, notice to already gone to the US, United States Secretary of Defence, Ash Carter. And I've sent one to the British High Commission here, Louise X. Lee in Wellington. I'm yet to send one to John Key, but it's already out online now that John Key's on notice before he passes his TPPA Act. His third reading, maybe today or tomorrow. It's too late. I've got this notice public now. On you, John Key, you've got a bounty on your head. We're using that TPPA on this land without title. I'm holding the title here with these chiefs, and you haven't got a title to this land to talk for it. You're forbidden from exercising your Admiralty, Vice Admiralty, over this Admiralty flag and the seal here of King William IV jurisdiction on these lands and through the world. Okay, so you've got notice, John Key, by this video and all these videos I'm saying, that I'm pointing your name out is in the High Court of Admiralty in London, ready to seize your property, all your belongings and everything, with the £1 trillion note already on your head. The police have got £1 trillion on each of their head, all the police in this country. They've got £1 trillion on their head. The British military, Navy, hasn't got an invite to come here to this 75 years of Navy in New Zealand, and you have the cheek to leave them out when they got you on these lands in the first place, came from Westminster. That's our partner. That's why you can't go anywhere near this flag and Britain, because they have the ruling authority over you, John Key, and Obama. The British holds the title of Admiralty from the King's Bench Court in Britain, London, UK, and here in the Waitangi Marae King's Bench Court. We're going in there, John Key, to give you notice your lease is terminated. Okay, I'm saying that in advance of what the chiefs will say. They'll either say terminate or extend your lease with new terms. New terms of occupation of land. You haven't got a clear title. We're still holding the clear title here. The clear title is right here. You see this? the Manukau Land Company title. Okay, right there. Chief Te Mati Manukau, Mohi Manukau, Chief Paramount, Chief Mohi Manukau, Te Mati Manukau the Fourth. Okay, he's got his coat of he's in the Freemasons. He's been Freemasons for 50 years. That's what he's wearing there as a Mason. Okay, he's the New World Order, the Manukau landholder of these lands and the four tribes. Yeah, four tribes in the northern region. I'll just read a little bit of it. It says here, Atua e wā, Oropuke waka, that's Mohi Manukau's, Ngāti whā Atua, Waitaha, that's the next waka. Then it's got Aotea. I can't read the next one. Anyway. A glass and try to read it. Okay, then it's got Tatara Koika, Koika, Tatara Koika, Te Mati Urimu Mohi Manukau Whakapapa. And it's got Manukau of Chatamarans, okay, the Moriori, okay. He's got, these are the wakas. Oropuke is his waka. Waitaha, the second one. Oropuke is 1100 AD. The Waitaha is 1175 AD. The Aotea is 1375 AD, Tatara, Kaika, Koika, settlers, 1275, Mataura, settlers, 1400, Arawa, 1400, Pākehā came in 1840, settlers. So that's the order of who got here. The Moriori, Ngā Atua Ewa, Orupuke Waka, Waitaha next, Aotea next, Tatara Kauika, I'll just say where they come under, that's the third wave. The first wave, Turi, yet Aoraki, native title. Aoraki, down to, where does it go? Lots of names. No, we won't go through that. I'm just saying it. The first wave came with Turi. Aotea. Okay. 1300 AD. 1275 was Waitaha. 1175 Waitaha. 1100 was the Orupuke Moriori. Moriori, Waitaha, Aotea. And then the Ngāpuhi's Mataura, first wave. That came under, the first wave came under, I'm trying to figure out one of the chiefs. Ooh, what a big thing. Anyway, I won't say any more. I'll just leave that for another day. I'm just saying, this is the title that I walk into Waitangi Marae King's Bench Court and pull it out. And it'll match up with Westminster, the Manukau Land Company there. It's all the lands at the Manukau heads here and other lands that was consolidated from the Australian New South Wales titles into the Manukau Land Company's titles. And that's where it went from there. Okay? Oh, somebody's here. Willie Peita. Hello, Willie.
Yeah, John,
yep. Yeah, it needs to be a new big one. It needs to be a big enough one, like the size of the New Zealand one, there. Yeah. Yeah, well, a synthetic one that's, can be replaced if it wears out. Just get one, you know, with, I think a bigger one would be about $150. Yeah, well, you need to get, yeah, so the flags, FLAGZ is a company in Auckland that makes them. And I'll let you know what it costs and what size. I'll sort that part of it out here with the flag company. And we'll organise the money for it, because it needs to be a nice shiny one to make a good entrance into, because it's going up the stair. Yeah. No. Well, I'll draft up all the papers for that, and so they go into that Marae court when we go there, and notify them inside. But I'll make notifications of intent, so that everybody knows what's going on, and keep in touch with you there. It's more important there in Hokianga, has a lot to do with what happens at Kororareka. Those two go together. Those people settled at Hokianga goes together with the people at Kororareka, okay? The history. That's why it's like that, because Moira Hoffman, she's a friend of mine, she's a Russel. And she told me all the Hokianga story and connected up with Russel. So she's the British one that I've got a lot of information from, of who's who, between those two places. Mm. That's talking from her, Britain, British. Well, she's New Zealand, but British. So, yeah, leave me the flag with me. I'll sort out the cost and the best material one, and the appropriate size that will match the one, the New Zealand one size. No, it's got to be done beforehand. You've got now till the 6th of February to organise everything so everybody's on the same page, right? Because it's very important. This is international. It's not just here. You're doing it in front of the world, ready for your ship that's not there yet to go around the world. You're going straight into trading around the world, and that's the part I've got to whip off to Westminster to sort that end out, and to get them us there. The flag's got to go up there at the same time afterwards. All right? And I've got to let the British Navy know our intentions here, why they're not coming on the 17th to the 22nd for the celebrations here, why they're not coming. You see? I'll sort that out. Okay, Willie. Yeah. Hey, there's Willie. It's a flag. Right? We're gonna get I'll get a flag sorted, a big one. For that ship. That ship and the other ship, there's two flags. That ship and the one at Kororareka. Okay? For the people watching, this is very important. For Kingi Taurua and the chiefs up there. We've got to get the native side right. We've got to get the native chiefs the right surnames to fit Westminster. You can't put an English-speaking name or a Maori name that doesn't match up. It's got to match up with the title on the other end. At the moment, it just looks Wānoa Manukau. That's it. And Hika, Hongi Hika. Those three names. it's put down on documents with seals. Okay, with seal and memorials. The Maui statue is a Tahitian memorial to the whole Pacific and the whole world for that matter. That belongs to Tahiti. That means Ngati Pro, Ngati Kahungu, Ngati Ngapuhi, Tainui, all the people who are Tahitian origins. Okay? We come from one waka or another. Mohi Manukau's waka is the Orupuke waka. That's in the Kaipara Harbour. Okay? I'm not going to tell you any more about it, but that's his waka. The Moriori's waka, Chatham Islands. Okay? That's where they come from. There's something hidden deep underneath that island that belongs to the Manukau people. It's got a village there called Manukau. That's the title. I'm going there one day to sort that out. He wanted me to go and sort that out before. Well, I didn't have time to do that. Anyway, that'll come as soon as we get this flag sorted. So the flag issue for those people watching, I'll sort out the flag here with Flags New Zealand, because I know the guy there. I was going to get, that's where I got the 20 flags from, to send to Prince Peter on Malta, to Eru Manukau over there. See, he was in the right place at the right time, but he went the wrong way, into the Saudis and the dirty money. Him and Charlie Hoheba went into the dirty money, because it was the gold they were following. I'm not following the gold. I'm following the pound note and the flag, where the flag went, and the pound note's going to go and build them all. Okay? And using a bit of logic here, it was the tools that were given to us. Right? We use the tools and the authority that was given to us to use on anybody else. Mucking around with this lot. Okay? We'll get a ship yet. A ship, a few ships, and no other way. There's no other way to do it here, because you've got to have the title. If you haven't got one of these, you just can't get into Westminster without that. You can't get into Westminster without that title. Okay, this here, I've got it on my site, this carving here, you'll see it. I'll explain that in another video. It's a parliament, okay? It's a parliament in native court. I'll explain it on another video one day. What Mohi's told me, I'll never forget. Okay, so that'll come out here. So that's all I want to say. I just have to go to the physio right now. I'm running late, better go. See you later, bye.